Hi, I'm Purenature, and as you can see, we are once again at the Alpha servers for Battle for Azeroth, and today we are going to check the island expeditions. Now, the island expeditions are like the Mist of Pandaria scenarios, but kinda better. On the island expeditions, you have four difficulties: normal, heroic, mythic, and PvP. On the PvE difficulties, normal, heroic, and mythic, you will be competing against AIs, and according to Blizzard, the AIs are behaving like normal players. So they might attack you, they might try to steal objectives from you, and generally they will be competing to beat you. So be careful if you see them and you can't kill them, or if you don't, they might ambush you and try to kill you. On the other hand, on the PvP difficulty, you will be competing against your enemy faction. By that I mean, if you are Horde, you will be against Alliance. If you are Alliance, you will be against Hordes. Now, that said, on the islands, you will join, and probably whenever you join an island, you will be seeing different creatures, different quests, different objectives, different items that you can interact with and get buffs and or Azeroth power and whatnot. Now, whenever you join an island on the island expedition system, every time you join, it will be different, even if the name is the same. Now, from what I have seen near the table that you queue for the island expeditions, that it's located on the Boralus Harbor, there are two vendors. One of those is selling grenades that you can only use on expeditions, warfronts, Zandalar, and Kultiras. It does quite a bit of damage. You can get a hidden cannon. I think it's the same, but I'm not sure. And there is also the trick vest. Absorbs. It's like a shield, so. And a shield and also deals damage on enemies around you. That's cool. And also, that is the Durkis. It's a shady trader, anyway. That's why he's selling ammunition and stuff. And then we have Alana. Alana gives you Links of Faith. That says that it roots everyone in 15 yards for 30 seconds. Again, you can use them only for island expeditions, warfronts, in Zandalar and Kultiras. Then we have the Light Prism that heals you, that you heal damage. No, when you heal damage, fire holy bolts at enemies in a cone in front of the caster. Okay. So probably that's for healers. I'm gonna check it since I will go as a healer spec. I'm gonna buy one. And we have the Sanctified Scroll. What that does? Calls down a shaft of pure holy light, empowering allies inside of the beam, with 10% increased damage dealt and healing them every 5.2 seconds. Okay, again, I will try to use that inside the expeditions if I need that. Now, let's get one of each and check them inside the island. Okay, we have pretty much... Where is the other thing? We have pretty much everything. So I will queue for the island expeditions now, and I will see you whenever the queue pops up. So here we are on the island expeditions after a really, really long queue, like 60 minutes or something like that. We will be starting to do stuff. So from now on, I will be cutting my gameplay, and I will edit it in a way that you can actually see what's more important, if I find anything interesting, and so on and so forth. And we are engaging with the enemy team. Oh, those are NPCs. Not NPCs, AI, I think. Let's see what we can do. When you heal. Okay. Okay, I'm disoriented. That stupid rogue. The AI rogue. Okay, what else we can do? I can use that. I guess I can use that. And... oh! And we can use that. So pretty much we used every consumable that we got from that. No, she died! So that is a dungeon inside a dungeon. The thing is that I don't know what we get. Probably we get Azerite, but I don't know if the enemy NPCs can come. I assume that the PvP, on the PvP queue, you will be able to interrupt the opposite team to. And that also reminds me the other Blizzard game, Heroes of the Storm, that there is a map that you go into mines and the other team comes to defend the boss or kill the boss and kill you and all that stuff. I don't know if I'm going. I'm healing good. Oh, don't turn it into me. And yes. Okay. That was decent. They are not regular NPCs, so they have different skills and stuff. I don't know. Because, okay, I see a hunter, I see a rogue, but also I see the dude that shoots bombs out of his hands. So I guess they don't follow the classes that the game has. Now let me see what that old chest does. So it gives Azeroth. Okay, okay, that's decent. I guess every item you see that you can interact with it, it will give you Azeroth or heal you, as we saw previously with the meats, foods and stuff. Away from those things. Let's get that. I think it gives us what? It gives us damage and maximum health. That's always handy. And it stacks, so... oh, it stacks. That's OP. That's OP. Really OP, actually. You know what those orbs reminds me? They remind me of Diablo 3 Rifts. That you never kill an elite or something like that. You get orbs that gives you progress, but that does not happen here. What I like is that that rogue, when he sees us, he always comes to PvP, even though he's outnumbered by 3-1. Ah, so pretty much whatever you kill, it says that how much. And we are done. Okay, my honest opinion is that it's fun, it needs a lot of work, but I think it takes too much time. I don't know if it was because we are under gear or we don't know what we were doing and we spent like 40-20 minutes PvPing with the enemy NPCs, but that was all. It's fun, actually, it's fun, it's fun. You will enjoy it if you play it with friends and have talk and laugh about that. So that's all about Island Expeditions. I hope you liked it, and if you do, give me a like, a comment and a subscribe. Thank you very much, and I will see you soon. Bye!